All right, on to the next section.
Once our signals are processed, they will typically be routed to some type of mixer. At its base, the matrix mixer is relatively simple. It's user assigned, and the output level is simply a sum of what is mixed in that output. The auto mixer, on the other hand, requires no user operator, and the output level is constant regardless of the number of open mics. The matrix mixer allows you to adjust crosspoint controls by adjusting the relative level of each input to each output. Theoretically, if your inputs enter the matrix mixer at a nominal level, changing the relative input and output levels should be simple. Crosspoint mutes can be enabled to turn routing on and off without changing the gains. Auto mixers are used mostly for conferencing and speech reinforcement and use an adaptive threshold for gating. The most important feature of the auto mixer is that it keeps the overall output level constant regardless of the number of mics open. We suggest that the maximum number of microphones, or max nom, be between 1 and 3, which makes sense if you think about it. You need one mic for the guy that's talking, another mic to argue with the first guy, and a third mic to tell the other two guys that they're both loudmouth jerks, right? Now, there are several controls in this component that you can use to fine-tune, but realistically, what you should focus on is the level above noise, which controls where you gate on. In this example, with 8 inputs, the adaptive algorithm will calculate an average noise floor. Then, when a microphone signal exceeds a certain signal, in this case 10 dB above the overall noise floor, the microphone will gate open. In this scenario, the nom is set to 1, and as you can see, there is no attenuation. Then, when I open 2 mics, there is 3 dB of attenuation. Then, when you have 4 noms, you get 6 dB of attenuation. You get the idea. Each doubling in the number of open mics will add 3 dB more in the total signal, so the component pulls negative 3 dB out by attenuating the overall output. Ideally, no matter how many mics I open, I'm never going to go over that initial level you started with at 1 open mic, ultimately keeping you out of the possibility for feedback. Next, let's talk about the Q-SYS gain sharing auto mixer, which is based on the Dan Dugan gain sharing algorithm. Its goal is to allow a maximum gain of 0 by allowing each mic to share the total available gain. In the case of one talker, that one mic is granted all the mixer gain. However, as the number of talkers increases, each mic is granted less of the total mixer gain. Now, in reality, gain sharing auto mixers work well in systems with fewer microphones. When your system needs over 8 microphones, or in installations with acoustical challenges, we strongly recommend using the gating auto mixer over the gain sharing auto mixer. Putting those things into an overall signal flow from left to right, you have inputs calibrated to negative 20 dB FS nominal with some standard EQ, your choice of auto mixer, and output signal conditioning to tune the room, and then the output blocks. One thing to note is that there are no user level controls for microphones ahead of the auto mixer. The auto mixers take the noise level in the room and the level at each mic into account when deciding who gates. So allowing user level control could be a problem here. When it comes to dynamic processing options for microphones, you could employ a compressor, which primarily is going to level off loud talkers. For spoken word, feel free to be fairly aggressive on these, but applying these to vocal performance, make sure to use that much more carefully. The drawback of the compressor is that it doesn't increase the level of quiet talkers. Your other option is to use an automatic gain control. With this, you get help for quiet talkers and loud talkers. However, it reacts slower than a compressor does. Furthermore, if the signal-to-noise ratio of that microphone is not tuned properly, then the automatic gain control will exacerbate the issue. For example, in most cases, a user can tune out constant static noise. But if the AGC is bringing noise up and down in volume, it gets harder for the user to ignore that issue. Sometimes in noisier installations, you might be tempted to put a noise gate before the auto mixer. Do not ever do this. This is a common attempt to solve a problem that should really be solved elsewhere. Remember, the auto mixer needs to know the noise level to decide who gates. A gate ahead of that will just confuse the algorithm.
All right, let's wrap up that subject here, and then we'll move on to the next part in the next video.